It has been almost a year since COVID-19 has closed down businesses here in Edmonton and across the country. And while most business owners are getting closer to reopening, live music venues are still left in the dark about what their future holds. And that has one Edmonton event space owner saying he's received no support from the province.
We closed March 12th. We were one of the first, probably the first, to shut down.
The stage and dance floor of the historic Starlight Room in downtown Edmonton has been empty since then. Co-owner Tyson Boyd says they've been able to scrape by on federal support. When that ends, it could be lights out forever at the Starlight Room.
We can sustain likely until June, and that is when the rent subsidy is at this point dissolves then. And it'll be a pretty quick closing for us then.
Adding to Boyd's frustration, the province announcing relaunch grants for nonprofit performance venues and churches, but nothing for privately owned performance venues.
So they have the advantage of A, not paying taxes. Number two, they are still allowed to operate at much larger capacities than anyone in the province. And number three, they are still allowed to collect donations from those people that come in.
City News reached out to Culture Minister Leela Ahir's office for comment. They say they provided loans of up to $20,000 for small business relaunch. Boyd says that's not enough. He says since the shutdown in March, he's been in contact with his NDP MLA David Shepherd, but has heard nothing from the province or Alberta Health Services. Boyd wants the province to reconsider, pointing to an independent report from West Anthem showing the ripple effect live music has on the local economy. The report showing here in Edmonton, the music sector has created over 7,000 jobs and contributes $1.3 billion to the local economy. Boyd says if his and other small venues go under, Central Canada could lose a lot of live music.
If we lose venues or markets within Canada, that stops international touring from coming into Canada, except maybe hitting Vancouver, Toronto, Montreal.
In Edmonton, Darcy Ropchan, City News.